decided to let black people have a month where they can teach their accomplishments and they can teach what great things we have contributed to this society. People talk about the greatest scientist was this and that. I believe the greatest scientist to ever live in America was George Washington Carver. In my opinion, he was the greatest, what you call it, horticulture, botanist. One thing about Mr. Carver said when he got up in the morning, he talked to his plants. First of all, he talked to God, then he talked to his plants. He was in tune with nature. You know, a lot of us, we're not in tune with nature. We become urbanized. I'm trying to go back to nature. I'm trying to plant me a garden and stop eating all this poison food. They say your child really don't have what they call that HD what? ADHD. Is his problem is he's eating the wrong food. Oh my God, help us right now. And when you eat the wrong food, it keeps you hyped up. It keeps you depressed. Allergies, come on here. Why? Because they're eating wrong. You take them off the wrong food and let them drink plenty of good pure water, and they'll heal up. Well, so much for that. This is Black History Month. My God, thank you, Jesus. Go with me to the book of Deuteronomy, the 28th chapter. Someone get our visitor a Bible. She got a Bible? And a Bible and give her, help find where it is. Deuteronomy is the fifth book in the Bible. And then someone give me Hosea 4 and 6. We're going to talk a little bit. I'm not going to hold you long because I'm on a 45 minute deal on this CD. So we don't want to hold you long. Deuteronomy 28, I'm sorry, 1 through 7, and Hosea 4 and 6. Deuteronomy 28, 1 through 7. God has always planned to bless his people when they would obey him. The reason why that I'm not blessed to the fullest degree is because maybe it's because I'm not in total agreement with God. And probably the same thing with you. You're not in submission to God. And because our people, over a period of time in slavery, didn't get into fellowship with God and they began to serve idol gods, then we ended up here in these Americas on a slave market. Remember that the black man sold us out because of what? And what? Money. Slavery was about money. I was listening to Dr. Gates. He's a professor at Princeton, Georgetown University in Washington, Baltimore area. He said that when the pilgrims, the priests, Catholic people came over here to avoid being enslaved, he said that 119 slaves, they call them servants, were sold in Louisiana. Now, what they were doing, he was trying to run, what you call that, your genealogy back. What's that guy that come on Good Morning America? He's a tall black guy. Y'all know who I'm talking about. Football, used to be ex-football player. Well, he was on the show, and he ran back to his ancestors. And he got so far back, and he said that your ancestor is tied with Charlemagne, the Emperor of Europe. But he ran it history down and said that y'all started in Baltimore and the priests. Isn't it strange how that the white people come over here to escape slavery and mistreatment and they started enslaving black folk? Well, anyway, to make a long story short, he said that your great-great-great-granddaddy was slave. They had his name and everything. And so, and the reason why they were sold was when the priests came here, they had all this farmland, and they produced tobacco. George Washington was a tobacco farmer and marijuana farmer. He grew marijuana and breeded black women. Come on here. Had babies by black women like they all did. Well, anyway, they run his lineage back, and he said that the priests sold him for $110,000, which today would be worth $6.5 million. And they went down to Louisiana and worked there on a farm because the college was going bankrupt, and they had to have a way to get some money. And the archives are in Georgetown University. Is that in Washington, D.C.? In Washington, D.C. Georgetown's Catholic, isn't it? I'm so glad they kept records back then. So what I'm saying can be proven. They're not going to pay the people back that they sold. So what they did is they named a hall after his great-great-great-great-grandfather. Hosea 4 and 6. What did it say, Mar? You got that? Go to Hosea 4 and 6.
My people are destroyed.
For lack of knowledge. For the lack of what?
Knowledge.
You know what the problem has been with black people in America? They've been fed the wrong knowledge. We already been over there when they said that the black man was cursed and he turned black, Ham turned black, and that's all been a fabricated lie. When it all began in the Garden of Eden and in Ethiopia, they were all black and brown people. What's new is white. Y'all looking at me. This is good for y'all. Some of y'all eyes gonna pop out in the mirror. But they had a way of hoodwinking you, thinking that white is right. They even make a survey now. They take these young black kids and they put these dolls. They put a black doll, white doll, and maybe a lighter doll, whatever. And they see which one the black kids gonna pick. And which one do the black kids pick?
White.
Why? Because they believe white is what?
Right.
And because they parents don't teach them their true history. Well, we're gonna talk just a little bit about, hold that point. Read it. My people are destroyed for the lack of knowledge, and what else? Because thou has rejected knowledge. When you reject the knowledge of God, anything can happen to you and your family and your descendants. Thank God that your family was strong, because those that didn't make it, they threw them overboard. The slave ship. But somehow we made it, because God had a plan for us. Read on.
I will also reject thee, that thou shalt be no priest toward me.
I'll also reject you, and you won't be a priest. Every black man should be the priest of his family. Somehow we got it terribly bad. And I feel, because a lot of black men don't have, was not raised, they wasn't, can I put it this way, wasn't privileged like me to have a mother and father in the home. That man in the home is supposed to be able to get control of them children. You know, when we did wrong back in me and Brother Fulbright day, there was no mercy. Oh, you gonna get it now. If you showed out in the grocery store, they'd whip your behind right in the grocery store. You showed out in church, they'd tear your behind up right in the church house. We had strict control. That's why I can't understand how people can throw beer cans on the church lawn and smoke on the church and thump the cigarette butts on the church. Come on here. When I was in the army, and most people, so many of them smoke, Every morning they get up and make you do police call. You walk that whole lawn and pick up cigarette butts. Well, I don't smoke. Well, I don't care. You pick them up anyway. Read on. What else it say?
That thou shalt be no priest to me,
mm-hmm.
seeing thou hast forgotten the law of thy God.
Thou hast forgotten the law, the word of God. Where do we stand as a people in America? Nowhere. White people tickle me, and I'm not being offensive to my sister there. Anytime I'm in a motel and I want that swimming pool by myself, all I got to do is go down there with my black self and jump in that swimming pool. Mario, what happened? They all what? Are y'all scared the water going to turn black or what? It's because of the teaching, false teaching, wrong teaching over the years. When I was coming up, they always taught that you're inferior and white people are superior. That's what the teaching they used to do. You don't go in that door. You take your black self around to that back door, the side door. But in the 60s, that all took a change. Went to an integrated school. We're going to have fun. We're going to be with white people. Yeah, right. Everything's all right till they call you the N-word. See, y'all young folk, y'all don't know nothing about this. But let me tell you what, they got a more of a sophisticated way of lynching you. And you don't even know it. Every time you pick up that cell phone, they listening to you. They know where, they know where your whereabouts is right now. They got a camera in Tulsa going off. How you think they find criminals? They got the camera on him. When they did that bombing in Baltimore, D.C., Boston bombing, they had him on camera. They found him in a boat. Big brother, get you. Come on, we on Black History now. Oh, my God. Has God forgotten our children? The public schools is a mess. If you don't believe me, ask the First Lady. Oh, my God, it's a mess up in here. We don't need people just to give these kids bags of pencils. And you know, when I was a custodian, I took out the trash. I see more pencils, more notebook paper, mold this, hadn't even been touched, and I had to throw it away. We need people to go up there to that school and see if these young black kids or people of color, if they can read. Help them to learn how to read. Because this next generation, they all drugged out, they all sexed down, they all messed up, and their children are not being raised. I can help Johnny now while he's small, but when Johnny gets to be a teenager, I can't help him. I can't pay his bail bonds. When I got in trouble, and my father them seen I was going to keep on doing the same old mess, they said, I can't help you, I got to take care of the rest of them. So when I got out, I got a job washing dishes, pay my own bail bondsman and lawyer. It broke me too. But I brought it on myself. In the book of Hosea, he said that I'm going to forget your children. What's the problem now? In most homes in black America, they don't go to church. They hate God. Want nothing to do with God, because God is a God of righteousness and holiness, and we don't want that. We want to live our lives the way we want to do it. We forget that the wages of sin is what? Death. There's death in the community. What else is that? Come on here. Okay, hold it right there. Hold it right there. We're going to talk about this man, Willie Lynch. Y'all ever heard of Willie Lynch? Willie Lynch did a number on black people. In fact, he pronounced a curse on y'all. I ain't cursed no more because I know my rights. Willie Lynch gave out the wrong information. And because we believed it, what was the problem when the slaves got over here? They could not understand the language. Lots of slaves that come over here, they were Hebrews. How I know that? Because some of the songs that they taught, I mean that they wrote, Swing Low, Sweet Chariot. There's a home in what? Beulah Land. Those were Hebrew slaves that wrote them songs over there because of their condition was so terrible. In 70 AD, in Rome, the Jews lived in Rome. After Titus came and destroyed the Jews, killed all over a million of them, the Jews did what? They scattered out. They scattered out in every nation of the world. So a portion of, I believe, of black Hebrews were caught up in the slave trade. The slave trade started in Ghana. Right now, they still have those holding quarters in Ghana where they imported slaves. Well, slavery was a very profitable business. You know, I'm surprised people like Frederick Douglass them wasn't lynched. You know, Frederick Douglass' daddy was, mama was white, and he was a mulatto, as they call him. Willie Lynch told the slave owner, stop killing the black man because he's very valuable stuff. I'm gonna give you a foolproof method that will enslave him for the rest of his life. And it'll probably go from 400 years to 1,000. Well, what was Willie Lynch's doctrine? Number one, he used the so-called flu method of dividing the slaves up by skin color. Come here, Mario. Come up here. Since we're nine shades of brown, you might not be out in the field too long. Yeah, kind of keep you in between. Huh? Come here. Elijah, can you come up here real quick? See, this foolproof method has been working for years. I guess you and Elijah are pretty close. Now, here you got three different shades of brown up here, don't you? You can't. Will he be a house? You be a house. A house, Negro. Okay, y'all can say that. Where would I go? Y'all even know that, don't you? Huh? Come here, sister. Come here. Come here. Yeah, come here. Now here we is. We got this big fine sister up here. Oh yes. And we're gonna keep her for breeding purposes. Oh yeah, we're gonna have a nice slave. Look how tall I am. Look at all. Oh, yeah, we're gonna have a good worker now. Huh? Is that all right? No, it ain't all right. But that's the way it was. All right? Thank you. Thank you. Sister, can you come up here? My sister right there. Yeah, come here, girl. Come here. Come up here. I like her because she's down to earth. Hey, y'all, we got a white woman in here. Now, this here was a no-no back in slavery days. Uh-uh. This is hanging situation here. Huh? Hey, don't even look at Miss White Woman. But I'm type of nigga, I'm going to look. Oh. Huh? But you know what? In slavery days, it was good white folks that helped black people. Thank you, baby. You ever heard of the Quakers? The Quakers stuck their neck out to help black folk. The Quakers worked right along with Harriet Tubman to get us out of that horrible situation. Don't blame the white man for everything. We were sold out by our own folk because of what? Money. Slavery wasn't just about skin color and that. It was about the money. Okay, he said divide them up with skin color and skin color and the texture of hair. I don't know how that got there. Come here, sir. Now my hair is woolly. But he got a different grade there. Look at all that curl. But he's dark, Lord have mercy. In the field. Huh? It's not a curse to be dark or black because God always dwell in dark places. God talked to Moses. Moses knew God was in a black cloud and he ran to it because God was in there. Where am I at now? Come on here. Willie Lynch. Okay. Then he taught us how to hate one another. Lord have mercy. How to despise one another and not admire one another. Then you divide them up by height and age. Don't nobody want an old gray-headed Negro. Come on here. Not unless you got plenty of money. So what did Willie Lynch do? He taught that, told the slave masters to indoctrinate your people in that. Well, if you don't believe what I'm saying, where is the murder capital of the world? Chicago. Are white folk killing black people? Who's killing black people? You ever heard of self-destruction? Okay, hold up. Get this one here, y'all. Put that on. Go to Deuteronomy 28 chapter. Evidently, black people must have a tie-in with the original Jews, who the original Hebrew Jews was black folk. Because in passages of scripture, it talks about a yoke being around his neck. Let me ask you this question. What group of people that you see and that you read about had a chain and a yoke around their neck? The American so-called Negro. Well, black people didn't want to come over here. These other people that Trump is building Mexico, South America, they want to get to America because America is a place where dreams can come true. I'm not anti-America. I think America is the best place to live. If you travel around the world, any of y'all travel around the world in Europe and all them other places, When I got back home from the army, I almost kissed the ground. People are starving in Africa because their leaders take all the money and forget about the people. America has become a blessing to me. Amen. My folk never did own a home. Now I've had four homes. Amen. And sold one of them. I mean, just being blessed. Where could I attain this? Nowhere but in America. But my people paid a price for it. Your people paid a price for it. 25% of all black Americans, according to Dr. Gates, you're all mixed with European. It's going to get higher than that now. Time magazine wrote an article 35, 40 years ago, said the browning of America. It ain't going to be too black and it ain't going to be white. It's going to be right in between. Hey, like OJ, it's going to be caramel colored. If things keep escalating the way it is now. Deuteronomy 1:28:1, what does it say? We're going to get this word in. I'm almost, come on.
And it shall come to pass.
And it shall come to pass.
If thou shalt hearken diligently unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
If you will hearken diligently, carefully, listen to me. The only way that you can hear God is you got to have an ear to hear him. Come on.
To observe and to do all his commandments.
To observe and do. Say, do it.
Do it.
To the best of my ability. God didn't say you was going to be perfect, but he said put effort and try. Read on.
Which I command thee this day.
Uh-huh.
That the Lord thy God will set thee on high above all nations of the earth.
God said, I will set thee. Ooh, look what God want to do for his people when they observe and do his commandments. He going to set them on high. Read on.
And all these blessings shall come on thee.
And all these blessings, not curses, but blessings shall come upon thee. Uh-huh.
And overtake thee.
And overpower you. See, when you obey God, you ain't got to do a lot of stupid stuff that folks is doing now. You just start obeying God and get in prayer and get in walking with the Lord, and this stuff just going to overpower you. On your job, they'll raise you up to be the top, as I say, top dog up there, the top one, if you obey God. Come on here.